But in life, you will always find different extremes. Some people will work for this worldly life in such a way that they forget that there is a day they have to die. Whereas you have another extreme where people will live in such a way that they forget that they are in this world. They forget for a moment that they have rights that need to be fulfilled of their spouses and family members. And they have people whom they need to interact with in the most beautiful manner. So sometimes on that extreme, you find people have a misnotion and misunderstanding that if you would like to be religious, you only need to spend your day fulfilling salah in seclusion without interacting with anyone in one corner of your own until the day you meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then you have the correct path. You have the middle path, and that is the path taught to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brought to us by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says quite clearly, وَكَذَٰلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. If you take a look at Surah Al-Baqarah, even though the verse may have been revealed on a different occasion, but the meaning of it is so broad. Allah says, and in this way, we have made you an ummah or a nation that is in the middle, that is very balanced. Every one of us needs to ask ourselves, how balanced am I? Is the scale that I have lopsided, or is it heavier on one side than the other? If it is the case, let it be slightly heavier on the spiritual, religious side, bearing in mind that we have rights to be fulfilled for us, upon us.